Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Delibia again. Hope you guys are doing fine. I'm looking good. I'm doing well. So today I brought you guys the long awaited video that I asked you guys on Facebook and some of the hair groups I belong to, if you guys want to see how I grew back my edges after losing them while I was breastfeeding my baby. And you guys were like, yes, I'm interested. More than 100 comments I got from especially the Trisha Natural Hair Group. So here I am. I have time to film this video today for you guys, and I'm excited because you all know that your girl cannot keep this secret anymore. I want to share and let you guys know how I grew my edges. So without further ado, let's get into the video. But first of all, if you're new to my channel and this is your first time, welcome. My name is Delphine. I do natural hair videos. Subscribe if you do find my videos interesting. Share with your friends, share with your groups on Facebook, wherever you are in, and let the channel grow bigger and more subscribers come my way. And I love you guys so much for stopping by and checking my channel out. But before we start this hair edges whatever, I would like to take you back to when I really lost all my edges. Like, my edges flew. Fly away, Peter. Fly away, Paul. My edges flew away, like they disappeared with the twinkle of an eye, and I was so shocked. But I read about it. I was not panicking. I knew I would grow it back once I stopped breastfeeding my baby. So I'll take you back to December, January, up to today. I'll get some clips of other videos I've created before in the past 3 months, and some pictures as well to make let you guys see how damaged and empty my edges were before we get into how I started treating it. So beside this, and I'll just jump into the tutorial straight to show you guys what I use from the beginning, what I'm still using, and if I added any other products, I'm going to let you know. But there are so few because I really did not want to get confused and start buying products here and there, so I sticked to what I really basically wanted. So without further ado, I'm going to jump in and start showing you guys the tutorial. But before then, let's just keep the part where I'll show you how my edges are presently when I've showed you the products I'm using. So yeah, so first of all, I knew that since my edges are breaking, I really need to make sure I moisturize my hair regularly, because when your hair is dry, it breaks like easily. So I made sure I had leave-in conditioner always. As you can see, from the beginning in December, January, I was using this coconut spray leave-in conditioner. If you live here in Sweden, I normally buy this in Ika supermarket. That's where I get it from, their product hair product line section. There you get this from there. It's about 50 krona or so. I can't really remember the price. This is just a new bottle I got yesterday. The other one is finished. I put something else inside to treat my hair that I will film in the next video. And you always need this. First of all, what I do every morning once I get up, I always place my leave-in conditioner, my oil and my cream very close to my sink where I brush every morning, at night when I'm changing to go to bed as well, to clean up my makeup or anything. I make sure I use them. They are very accessible for me to use regularly, so I don't skip any day or two without my hair being moisturized. That was just my secret, or is still my secret. So what I do is get my leave-in conditioner. If it's in the morning, I'll spray my edges very well, and then the next thing I will use is my Jamaican and lime castor oil. It doesn't matter if you get the same brand, but just Jamaican castor oil is very enough, whatever one you have. This is a lifesaver. Like, this was the main and is still the main oil I'm using strictly on my edges. I can use any other oil inside my hair, like olive oil and the rest, but this I make sure morning and evening I apply on my edges and massage it very well until my edges are feeling very warm, and then I let it be. And then the next thing I add on top of the castor oil is my shea butter mix that I whipped myself. I do have a video and I always link it in most of my videos. If you're interested to check it out, I'll link it in the description bar below, and also maybe leave a link above for you to check how I whipped my shea butter. So these are the three main things I started using from January, I think end of January. I went to the UK, I bought some other stuffs, and I got this hair repair coconut oil and baobab hair growth oil. This one I started using this from the 1st of February up till now. This is what I'm using right now, because I took my castor oil, poured a good quantity inside this hair growth oil, because it's easy for me to apply with this bottle, because you just scroll it up and then you like easily apply it on your hair. So that's what I did. Once it's getting finished, I make sure I add more castor oil into it. So I'll try and see if I can get more of this hair growth oil. But the main thing inside here, because it changed the color, is the castor oil that has changed the color like this. I placed a good quantity of castor oil inside here and easily apply it on my edges, massage it. So this is what I've been using from the beginning of February up to today that I'm making this video. I just did the same procedure on my hair. So I did this morning night all through. You have to be consistent. You really have to be consistent. And one more thing that is very important if you are trying to regrow your edges is to avoid hairstyles that will tension your edges. I have not plaited any braids or whatever protective style that will pull my edges. I just let my edges to be and breed. That's what I did. So you cannot be growing your edges at the same time you're going to a hairstylist that will tension your hair with braids and you start putting them in updos and all whatnot. No, don't do that, please. If you're trying to regrow your edges, just give a few months and let your edges be on their own for them to grow in peace. So yeah, and after this Canto leave-in conditioner mist that I use is finished, this is water I placed inside today because I needed more moisture on my hair. So like What I'm saying is you need a liquid, you need oil, and you need a cream, because in the absence of my leave-in conditioner, let's say my this one got finished today, and if I had not bought this one, I've not opened it yet, I just use my water. And me, the essential thing is that your hair is not dry, so water is a good moisturizer. Just spray your head with water and then you apply your castor oil, massage it very well morning and night. Then you make sure you preserve your hair when you're going to bed with your satin or silk hair scarf that you have, hair cap or a scarf, whatever, but it should be either satin or a silk, because what I realized is once you moisturize your entire hair and your edges as well, when you go to bed with your satin bonnet and your silk, it doesn't soak the oil and the moisture in your hair like a regular net or whatever cotton cap or whatever you use, scarf to tie your hair to sleep. You end up drying your hair because it soaks away all the moisture and the oil, and you get up the next day, your hair is so dry and damaged. So this is a must have if you're trying to grow your edges. Another easy way is to get a satin or a pillowcase that you can just sleep on it, so that your hair does not cause any friction while you're sleeping as well, to make sure your hair is growing and retaining the length that you need. And that's what I've been doing basically for the past 3 months. You guys can see I am not using any magic. I have showed you from the beginning of the video how I totally lost all my edges and how I have been consistently applying it morning and night on a daily basis from December, January, February, March, and we are now in April. I think today should be the 11th of April, a Thursday, that I'm filming this video, and I'll just show you guys my edges today and you judge for yourself if it's working or not. So I'm also going to let you guys know that for the past 2 to 3 weeks now, I have consistently been using rice water on my hair. I'm going to film that video next after this video comes up live, because you guys have been waiting for this video like forever. I'm going to show you guys how I use my rice water that is making my edges to grow longer. My edges are growing from what I've told you guys, but now I see that it's growing longer, that I can even twist my edges. Like, seriously, I'm going to show you guys what I put inside my rice water that is giving me hair growth like crazy. So yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Right now I'm just going to come closer so that I show you how my edges look right now. I just placed my hair in a puff and basically it is how my edges are right now. As you can see, they have grown so well. You can see from the video that there was no hair entirely in this section, but right now look, I can even, for example, I can twist my edges right now into this smaller twist. Seriously, I'm going to share with you guys in my next video how I use my rice water, what I add inside my rice water is doing magic on my hair. Can you guys see how I just twisted my hair? Check the video from the beginning if there was any hair in this particular place. Like, I can basically twist all my edges right now. Are you seeing the growth? Maybe you're not seeing it very well. Like, seriously, I'm super excited. I like to try things for a while. If it's working, before I share it, I don't just come and say, oh, do this and your hair will grow, do this and your hair will grow. I try it for weeks, and if I see results, then I come to my channel to share with my lovely subscribers. So as you can see, there is tremendous growth right now from the beginning of the video, you saw how damaged my edges were, and now I am proudly twisting my edges. I'm doing this for you guys to see, because there are a lot of Thomas in this my channel. People want to see before they believe. So this is me twisting my edges right now. You saw from the beginning of the flashback videos that I put together before we start this video, these edges were gone, like they traveled, but now they are back. So yeah, as you can see, I'm twisting for you guys, although you are messing up my hairstyle right now, but I'm doing this for the Thomases that want to see before they believe. So yeah, I hope this video was helpful or is helpful to some of you guys, and do this and your hair, your edges will come back to life like where they went to. They'll come back and you'll be so happy. I'm so happy. Thank you guys for watching this video. I love you all. Ciao, see you guys.